obsessing with self-improvement and self-development can get into the cycle where you are doing more of trying to improve yourself, but maybe you are not taking much action. So it's easy to get into this place where you're thinking, well, once I address this trauma, then I'll be able to get myself out there and I'll be able to attract that person that I want. Now, I get it. It sounds a bit hypocritical coming from me, considering I've written 2 books on dating and relationships. I have this channel and I also offer coaching sessions. However, I am truly convinced that the best way to land is on the job. So the best way to actually find out about those things that may be stopping you from attracting that relationship that you would like is to actually putting yourself out there and getting on that dating app and going on that date, because I think that is the best self-improvement that it could be out there. And also have faith in yourself and trust in yourself that, you know what, no matter what kind of man the universe throws my way, I'll be able to handle this. And if it's not going to be my person, then maybe it's going to be the lesson that I need to learn. And think about the person that you were 5 years ago, how you handled yourself, how you were in relationships, how you were maybe when you were dating. I'm pretty sure that you have come a long way. Like this video if you feel that you actually have come a long way and you learned a lot of things. And this also gets me to the next point, is that sometimes obsessing over self-development turns you into this person who is actively looking for those red flags. So you go and meet someone, you are talking to someone, maybe not even face to face, maybe you just met on a dating app, and every interaction you are just so vigilant and you're looking for those red flags and you're looking what could go wrong. Look, I totally understand why you're doing this. You are tired of wasting your time. You are tired of people that are just sucking your energy. You are tired of repeating the same story over and over again, where you match with someone, you chat for 2 weeks, then you meet and you're like, nothing there. I wasted another 2 weeks. But it's not really waste of your time, because with every interaction, there is always something new that you can take from that. And looking for those red flags is extremely exhausting. That is why when you sign up for this dating app and when you're talking to people and you're looking for, oh, what is going wrong? This is why you're feeling so down. This is why you're feeling that this is draining your energy, that you cannot do this anymore. So how instead you can maybe introduce some playfulness, lightness, and ease into the whole process. And look, I totally get it, it's not easy. However, I just saw this lipstick, so I was like, okay, I'm gonna use this. Now, imagine I'm holding this lipstick just like this, right? But if I'm holding it like that, clenching my fingers into this fist and just holding it like that for these few seconds that I'm talking to you, it's already hurting. You see, it's already hurting. Wow, now I really pushed it. It's proper hurting. So think about it with online dating, or when you're going out and you're going on those dates. Are you going to be holding it lightly and being taking every experience as it is? Or are you just going to be so vigilant and causing yourself so much anxiety and frustration? Which one makes this process a bit less frustrating? Because yes, I know it is frustrating. However, sometimes what happens is that you are so vigilant to all the red flags, you are looking for those red flags, but when it comes to the obvious things, you cannot see them. So you absolutely ignore the biggest red flags. And what could be some of the biggest red flags is when you meet someone and you ask them what they're looking for and they're trying to avoid the question, or they clearly tell you that they're too busy with their work at the moment, that they're not in the place where they want to have a long-term relationship, where they want to start the family, and this is what you truly want. However, you tag along and you think, maybe I'll change their mind, maybe I'll do any of those things. I hope you're smart enough now to be in a position where you don't actually think that you're going to meet someone and you're going to change their ways and you look at this person as a project, because I think it's much easier if you can be like, okay, what are the things I can accept? Maybe as the time goes by, we will evolve in something else, but can I accept this person in front of me for who they are? But also not ignoring the way they're showing up, what they are telling you, and do their words match their actions? And if their words don't match their actions, maybe don't ignore that behavior and address it. Now, another huge dating mistake that I think you should avoid at all costs is waiting too long to meet them in person. I know that everyone's preference is different. I was on the call with this lady the other week and she told me that she's comfortable meeting someone after maybe 2 weeks of chatting with that person. And I remembered when I was single and I was on dating sites and I would find 2 weeks a bit of a long window, a bit of too frustrating, and I would think, okay, let's just get on with the program so then I can either eliminate this person or think, okay, this maybe could be a potential. So this is absolutely up to you what feels comfortable for you and how long do you think you should actually talk to someone, maybe on a dating site before you meet in person. But don't make it too long, because sometimes what happens is that you are talking to someone online and very slowly you are getting attached, and then you build this fantasy world thinking that something may happen, but then maybe you meet in person and you realize that this person is not who you thought that they were, and they're catfishing you, they're not even single, and the list goes on. And I think the sooner you meet in person, the easier it is to establish those things. Tell me in the comments, what do you think is the right amount to talk to someone online before you meet face to face? Now, the next two, I think you have to avoid at all costs. If you find yourself someone who is either getting attached too soon, or you find yourself a bit more on the anxious side, you also find yourself that sometimes you get invested too soon in people, don't make your dates too long. I know it is extremely exciting when you finally meet someone and you feel like, yes, maybe something could happen there. I feel the connection. I want to spend time with this person. I want to get to know this person as much as I can. And I totally understand this excitement. However, if you're someone who gets attached easily, if you're more on the anxious side, create a bit more space, set boundaries, so you have also a bit of the time to recover from that interaction. And I'm not saying that when you go on a date you have to recover and all these things, especially if you are not grabbing onto the lipstick if you are able to approach it with more ease, but take it slow. And when you're thinking that you're take it slow, take it even more slowly. Which gets me to the next point, is that you should avoid getting intimate too soon. Sex in the City has messed up our minds, making us believe that, oh, you can just sleep with someone and then it doesn't matter. You can sleep with someone the next day and it's just fine. But the reality is different, and you get attached to those people that you sleep with. And if you don't get attached, well, I think there is probably something a bit off with you. I'm sorry, but I truly believe that. If you ever had maybe a one-night stand, and if you reflect back on that, can you really put your hand on your heart and say, you know what, I was unbothered, it meant nothing to me? But if you like really ask yourself, dig a bit deeper, did it really mean nothing? Now, the next one is for you. If you think, well, lucky are those who find people that they want to have long dates with, lucky are those that find people that they want to be intimate with, because I've been on so many dates and I'm just not meeting anyone that I'm that interested in. So if you find yourself in that situation where you are maybe go on a date with someone and you feel that nothing is there, however, then you are not confronting that person. You are not sending a polite text message saying, look, I had great time, maybe the connection that I want wasn't there. So you're just tagging them along and thinking, well, I'll just keep responding to those texts, and then as the time goes by, maybe he asks me out, I'll say I'm busy or something, or maybe you just go for a free meal even though you are not interested in that person. I think that's a bit icky, and especially if you are a subscriber on this channel, I would be be very surprised that you would exchange your valuable time for a free dinner. No, I would expect more from you. Yes, I am judging you right now. If you're not a subscriber, then please subscribe. I know it's uncomfortable confronting someone, especially if you are a little people pleaser. You just want to be liked. You want good vibes and nothing else. I think it's just great manners and a standard that you hold yourself to. Try that also on dating apps. I remember when I was on dating apps and then I met someone and I was not interested in these other conversations that I was having with these other matches. And I send the messages saying that I met someone and I don't want to continue this conversation. And they were so appreciative. And they said, look, you seem like a great person. I wish you all the best. And I really appreciate that you didn't ghost me. Another huge dating mistake to avoid if you want to attract love is settling. Now, when I say settling, I don't mean that, oh, you're making a compromise because you're choosing a short guy and you are into 6 foot whatever. You are choosing a guy that you don't like his nose, or maybe he's not making as much money as you would like, all these kinds of things. No, when I say settling, I mean that you met someone, he kind of looks good on the paper, you are sick and tired of going on dates, he's treating you right, finally you're not lonely during weekends, and you're also getting sick in your stomach just thinking about you single at a Christmas table, yet again being asked, why are you single? Is there anything wrong with you? Why are you so picky? So you're thinking, maybe I should stop being so picky. When you really look at it, you're thinking, well, do I really enjoy time with him? Maybe I'm better off just by myself. It's almost like you have to convince yourself to be with this person. I think it's just not right. If you have to be convincing yourself to choose a man, to be with him, maybe this is not the right person for you. And I'm not talking about when maybe you are going from, you used to date toxic men and now you are finally dating good, decent men and you are trying to relearn your patterns and you're trying to distance yourself from drama that you are so used to. I have a video on my channel where I talk about why dating a good man feels so strange if you are used to this, you know, all the drama and all the hot and cold treatment and you don't know when you're going to hear from again. But that's different. Now this one, you may be feeling some resistance and you may be thinking, well, my situation is different, you don't know, or maybe this doesn't mean anything. Oh yeah, we just have a coffee sometimes, we have a dinner sometimes, maybe he calls me sometimes. However, I think you should cut the contact with your ex, and also if you have a friends with benefits situation, a situationship, whatever thing that is, if your goal in the next 6-12 months or whatever, 2024, is to meet the person that you truly want to bond and have a relationship with. And I remember when I was holding on to someone and my girlfriend told me and I just thought, well, you don't understand, my situation is different. But then once I finally let go of that, then I was able to attract a very different kind of person. It's almost like a man around you, they can almost smell it. Because energetically you are still there. You are still there with your thoughts, with your energy, engaging with your ex or having that boy toy or whatever you want to call it on the side. Another way you may be blocking someone truly special coming into your life is not making a place for them. And what do I mean by that is that when someone wants to plan a date with you, you say, well, Thursdays I have my Pilates, Wednesdays I have my HIIT and core class, Tuesdays I do Zumba, Saturdays I spend time with my girlfriends. So basically all that is left for him is Thursday 3 p.m. And are you doing that because you want to show that you are this high value woman, I don't really like that expression, who's got her calendar so busy and you have such a rich life, which is something that I really encourage you to have, a rich life and not to wait for a man to entertain you or do all those things that you want. However, there is a difference between having that life and then subconsciously blocking the person coming into your life because you simply physically don't have any time for that and you're not willing to make any time for that. So just maybe reconsider your calendar when someone wants to ask you out. Another way you may be pushing people away is when someone tells you how great you are, when someone is interested in you and you kind of push them away. Maybe you have a lot of experience being in abusive relationships with narcissists where it's always about them and they don't even take the time to listen to your dreams, values, needs, aspirations, or can't even stay present with you for 10 minutes. Or it could also be that someone now is telling you how great you are and you think, well, they can't see the real me. And sooner or later, they will discover how flawed I am. Once they discover how flawed I am, they will just run away. So you're just not used to this dynamic. So for you, it's easier to be with someone that you can be chasing and being, yes, yes, look at me and let me prove you how great I am. So when you meet someone who is the opposite, who already thinks that you're great, you simply don't know how to receive that love. So you have to push them away. As crazy as that sounds more comfortable to you. Maybe I'm telling this from my own personal experience, who knows? Another way you are pushing people away when dating that may be truly interested in you is that you are being the ice queen. You're being the ice queen by not letting people into your world, by not sharing anything vulnerable about you. You just want to show the perfect, polished side of you. And what happens in this kind of relationship is that you end up feeling very lonely because you sit across the table, you are in the same bed with this person, and then you realize that you are two strangers. You don't know each other. And look, I truly get it. It is very scary to let someone into your world because you think, well, I am so flawed. The moment they see that, they will run away. But maybe if they do want to run away, maybe that person shouldn't be in your life in the first place. And I'm not saying that you should be sharing your biggest childhood traumas and your biggest life challenges on the first date. No, but gradually you share some of those moments. And then who knows, maybe you will meet a person who will help you in the future when hard times come and can hold your hand and can be there for you. But if you're not willing to let anyone into your heart, then you know what happens? You just end up attracting an emotionally unavailable man. And maybe one of the reasons you've been choosing emotionally unavailable men, it's not because that you are so unlucky, but because you are feeling more comfortable when he's built that wall in front of him, so then you can stay in this comfort zone as well, where you don't really have to share that many things about yourself, because the truth is, he's not really that interested anyway. Another thing that may happen when you are dating, especially if you just met someone that you're really excited about and you like, is that you neglect yourself. Now, you neglect yourself not just by you're not doing your usual exercise routine, maybe suddenly you started eating crap because this person eats crap. No, but it's more also about you neglecting parts of yourself and who you are. I think especially that happens if you are a very feminine woman, so you're more flowy, you are adjusting to maybe a different environment and to this another person. And I think that is beautiful, but it's also important to remember who you are, because who you are is also the reason that this person that you met fell for you in the first place. So you do not have to change yourself in order to feel that you are good enough and then you will be the right fit for this person. It's important that you also don't neglect yourself and maintain parts of you that are very important to you. This one, you may not have awareness when it comes to that, but you use dating to seek validation. So every time someone likes your profile on a dating app, every time someone comments on how great you look, every time you get that new date, you are there taking all the compliments, admiration. It's your way of seeking validation. And maybe you're using the whole dating process to feel that you are good enough, that you matter, that you are attractive. It's almost like likes on Instagram, right? You're getting those likes and this perception that, yes, I do matter, I am important. But I think it's just, I think it's very sad. And if you do realize that you are using dating as to get validation from strangers, then maybe that's something you could address. Maybe you could go back to the drawing board and ask yourself, what is the reason that I'm dating? What are my intentions? What kind of person would I like to attract? How would I like to show up? And what am I doing at the moment that maybe is stopping me from attracting that person that I would like? And the last one, you have an online dating profile that is full of red flags. And this is the video you need to watch to find out more about that. Please like if you found this useful, share with your girlfriend, subscribe for more, and thank you so, so much for watching.